Mutation. It is the result of evolution. It's a process that takes many years, but it has allowed us to adapt to our ever-changing environment.
But seriously, we need like Wolverine claws or teleportation, telepathy, or at least Cyclops optic blast. I mean, come on. Man, I felt like Professor Xavier in like every starting of an X-Men movie. You know, now that I think about it, I should really give a review on X-Men Apocalypse. Oh well. But yeah, Cyclops Optic Blast. I mean, who hasn't dreamed of shooting energy beams out of their eyes? And out of all the people in the Marvel Universe, Cyclops is the most notable character for doing this. And for some time, I've been a little confused on how his power is supposed to work. But today, it's time for a theory. Now, it says here that Cyclops possesses the mutant ability to project a powerful beam of concussive, ruby-colored force from his eyes. His powers were originally believed to be ambient energies such as solar radiation, photons, and cosmic rays absorbed and metabolized by his body into concussive blasts that are released from his eyes. However, the energy supply of his optic blasts are later revealed to be part revealed to originate from a non-Einstein universe that opens up whenever he uses his optic blasts. Yeah, that's one thing I never really liked about him. I mean, I always thought of it simple, but turns out it's from another dimension, basically, from his eyes. I've learned that quite a while ago. So first, we need to know what these optic blasts are made of and how they're produced. So let's continue reading. Cyclops' eyes are not the only organs that utilize the visible spectrum of light to see around the world. Cyclops' mind has a particular psionic field that is attuned to the forces that maintain the apertures that have taken the place of his eyes. Because his mind's psionic field envelops his body, it automatically shunts the other dimensional particles back into their point of origin when they collide with his body. Okay, now basically what they're seeing here is Cyclops has a psionic field surrounding his entire body. Psionic meaning it's more psychological, it's more mentally based. And basically, he's immune to the effects of his blast. Like it says here, thus his body is protected from the effects of the particles, and even a thin membrane of his eyelids is sufficient enough to block the emission of the energy. And that's so true because his brother, Havoc, once shot him with similar blasts, and Cyclops was not affected. And it says here the synthetic ruby quartz crystal used to fashion the lenses of Cyclops' eyeglasses and visor is resonant to his mind's psionic field and is similarly protected. We'll get back to that in a minute. It also says here the extra dimensional supply of his energy for Cyclops' eye blast is practically infinite. Thus, so long as Cyclops' psionic field is active, which, as they say, is constant, you know, unless if he somehow loses that psionic field, aka dying or losing his ability altogether. But yeah, other than that, there's a potential to emit energy. The only limit to his eye blast is the mental fatigue of focusing constantly. After about 15 minutes of constant uses, his psionic field subsides and allows only a slight leakage of energy to pass through the aperture. Okay, we have enough information we need here. First off, we need to figure out what this eye blast is made of. And then figure it out. The first sentence here, Cyclops' eyes are not the only organs that utilize the visible spectrum of light. And It also says here, it automatically shunts the other dimensional particles back into the point of origin when they collide with this body. Particles, spectrum of light, and there's another name for light, electromagnetic radiation. So his blast is part of that spectrum, and as I've showed it before in the How Kryptonite Works video, we're gonna use that same chart again. And guess what? Since his optic blast can be seen, it's visible light, you know, red colored, according to this chart, it's right below UV rays. So let's go back to the beginning. First off, we all know that Cyclops can't fully control his powers. Whenever he opens his eyes, the eye blast comes out of his eyes. That's because when he was a kid, he went through a lot of traumatizing events. So he has never had control over his powers. And since, as they say, this power comes from another dimension, basically his eyes is in a way like a portal to another dimension. And all this energy is just being exerted from that dimension, aka his eyes, outwards. There's also another point that proves this theory. His glasses. Remember, like we said before, his glasses has ruby quartz inside of them. So it basically blocks his power, so he's able to see without shooting anything away. And as I stated before in the How Kryptonite Works video, I stated that depending on the frequency of the type of radiation, it's able to pass through certain materials. So basically, the particles from this dimension that they keep talking about is not able to pass through these ruby quartz. Remember, the electromagnetic spectrum acts as both a wave and particles at the same time, called wave-particle duality. In fact, here's another thing I would like to show you. In the X-Men Apocalypse movie, there's one point where Beast gives Cyclops his new glasses and says that basically, it keeps his powers within a vector field. And I was interested in that and I looked it up. Basically, a vector field is usually shown as a collection of arrows going in certain directions. Those arrows are basically a representation of the direction in which waves, gravitational forces, magnetic forces, and in this case, particles are moving. So basically, the vector field is just a pattern showing how these energized particles are being contained between Cyclops' eyes and his glasses or visor. And it makes perfect sense that these particles could be contained by ruby quartz. Because remember, visible light is right under UV rays. UV rays could be deflected by aluminum foil. So of course, ruby quartz has to be denser. But there is one more thing. The concussive force. Now, his beams could be narrowed down to like a size, well, to the width of a pencil. And could be so huge and so powerful, it could punch holes through a mountain. Heck, at one point at full power, Cyclops used his optic blast to blast the Hulk, who was walking towards him at the time. It peeled off most of the Hulk's skin, but the Hulk still walked up, grabbed Cyclops in the face, and contained the blast and just threw him down. There is only one way that's possible. Density. If the density of this blast is, well, dense enough, it could provide a much powerful force. And in order for this to occur, then there must be a high emission of these energized particles from Cyclops' eyes or dimension. So, that's an increase in intensity. And like I said before, intensity is the emission of particles for a certain period of time. So the intensity must be so high, it allows his blast to have a high density to cause such a powerful force. And that's it. That's basically how his powers work. But still, even if our powers come from strange and complicated universes or dimensions, I don't care. We need some of those cool mutations. Heck, maybe it could be a Wolverine or definitely Nightcrawler. I want to be able to teleport. But what do you guys think? Do you agree with my theory or do you have a theory of your own? Comment below and I'll see you guys next time.